Hello guys, welcome back to the channel.
We're back like we never left. We just finished watching Squid Game and man,
guys, this is literally the most trending TV show right now.
Overall, it had a very engaging story and some wild moments for the first 8 episodes. The last, not so much.
And we have some strong reservations about
strong feelings about that last
about
episode.
About that finale,
guys. It didn't just do it for us.
No, it did not.
Gi-hun's, am I saying it right? Gi-hun? Are you Gi-hun?
You guys,
Gi-hun's character development, they did a full 180 from what we expected.
Exactly.
I mean, how do you go from being debt poor, a gambler...
Exactly.
And then suddenly, because a few people die, in which you expected them to die,
fully expected them.
Now say, oh, money isn't worth it. Money isn't the answer. That people's lives are more important than money. And you neglect your daughter and everything that you were facing before you went into the game.
It just doesn't make any sense to me.
Don't make no sense. Don't
I mean, that's
no
what
sense.
We got from the character from the beginning, just like we said. He's a gambler. You went into this game fully aware of what was going to happen.
The premise.
You made the decision to go back.
The premise of the game is you lose, you die.
It's that simple. It's survival of the fittest. Nobody in there will hesitate a second to kill you.
Admittedly, like when they went into the game at first, they didn't know. So we grant you that ignorance card.
Yes.
But then when you went back, what the hell were you expecting?
You were fully aware of what was going to happen.
That they would let 10 of you walk out of there like with merry songs.
As the show progressed, each day with each game, it was becoming very aware that one person, one winner, takes it all.
You know, the way I look at it, but Gi-hun, I hope I'm saying his name right. Gi-hun is the architect of his own downfall. Please let me just say that, of his own downfall, because this guy, first of all, getting loans from loan sharks. Abandoning his wife during labor, even though he had one meager excuse. Thirdly, the stepdad gave him the money for his mother's treatment.
You know, that's the part that doesn't even really sink well with me.
His pride didn't let him accept the money.
I mean,
which he would have kept his mother on treatment before
exactly.
he went back
yes,
into the
that's,
game.
Yes, that's exactly what I'm even talking about. That part just didn't sit well for me. He should have collected the money, put his mother in the hospital, and then go back into the game.
You know, then before he comes out, you don't understand. That's even a better... because you're not even sure if you're going to live through it.
I mean, what if he died and his mother dies as well? Like, do you understand?
You know, that whole thing of him not being okay with everybody dying because of money, it's quite stupid, because he was directly responsible for the deaths of the other group during the tug of war game. So he knew.
Why did you decide to grow a conscience at the last episode?
They pitted them against each other. See how it happened, group by group, then two groups of two.
Yes.
Then the last people were obviously going to face off against each other.
Obviously.
And Sebiok, I like her name. Sebiok stopped him from killing Sang-woo.
Because he told him that, okay, you know, she told him that this is not who you are. Da, 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 da,
yeah,
da.
So we don't even know what would have happened if she didn't stop him. Maybe he would have killed Sang-woo. He hated Sang-woo because Sang-woo was the opposite of what he was.
What he was.
Which is an idealist. Like, everybody should have it. Like, we could all be in groups and be happy and
yeah,
everything.
Yeah, but Sang-woo, you know, that is even... I think I like Sang-woo's character development better. The guy was realistic.
Man knew what
he was there
for.
He was going to get that money and he was going to get out of that place. Like, he had things to do with that money in case some of you don't.
You now being angry because Sang-woo died, which he killed himself. Sebiok died by circumstance, because if Sangu didn't even kill her, she would have died from blood loss. I don't think the people, the Squid game,
or anything.
Yeah, they were going to treat her. I don't think they would have done that. So she was going to die either way. So where is your anger? That's what I want to ask.
I guess where's him being angry at Sangu, though. I guess him being angry at Sangu.
But he chose to spare Sangu at the end and said actually, two of them should, that there should be no winner. So two of them will go
without that money. Everything that has happened,
hell no, bitch. I was going to kill myself so that you take the money and go home.
Do something better.
Like, at least help my mother. Help the people that you feel pity for. Help the people that you are angry that they died.
Exactly.
That they died in the game. So you help their families. You help what they were, the situation, see what they were forced into because of debts and stuff like that.
Yes. I mean, as much as everyone that you knew Ali, you knew Sebiok, you knew Sangu's mom, help them. Okay. So you
it wouldn't, with that amount of money, it wouldn't even be hard to even find out information about these people.
So now Gi-hun has left the game as the winner.
456 billion won.
Just sitting in his account.
I mean, if it was such an evil money, why not give it away? Huh? Why not give it away, Gi-hun?
So it's the fact that he waited months for me. I mean, from what we can see, it could be up to a year.
Lived as a beggar.
Lived as a dirt poor beggar, like a
even asking his bank manager that came to give him proposals for investment.
Asking him for 10,000 naira. Asking him for 10,000 won.
What a douche. You know, the thing about this finale is, if he was traumatized for a period of time but got his priorities set back,
I definitely would have loved it.
Yeah, I would have understood it. But to be like, no money, because first of all, this game happened. I know experiences can change someone, but come on, this guy is an addictive gambler.
Number one,
money
went into this game,
has been kicked down by financial conditions all his life.
Went into this game so that he can keep his daughter. I mean, I don't see how he lost sight of that, especially his daughter. I mean. In the game, he was literally caring about everyone, caring about Sebiok, he cared about, you know, those people on his team. So to just lose all of that now,
don't make no
that
sense.
You even have money. Don't okay, so sense. For some reason he gets back himself. I mean, after listening to Il-Nam talk about why he created the game, which in my opinion still doesn't make sense to me.
I don't even know what it makes sense, because rich people do dumb shit when they have a lot of money. But the thing that, what about Il-Nam changed his perspective on spending the money?
Let's just say about, you know, that the bet they had about that beggar sitting outside there. And that was, I guess that's what, you know, clicked in his head and be like, okay,
yeah,
I have this money, I should help. It's what we're saying, that he didn't need to wait that long to understand that, okay, you got this money through these means, I should help people.
They're in the same situation as me. Like, what would have happened?
It's a no-brainer.
You know, at the finale, when he was at the airport and he saw that guy playing that red card, card game with another guy, what would have happened if he told the guy, what are you going through? Let me help you. You know, that's...
Instead of just losing his shit completely.
Telling him, I forbid you from playing the game.
Like, who the hell are you? Okay. So, he snaps back into it. Dyes his hair red, which again makes no sense to me.
Don't get me started on that. The director says to show his
pull
anger.
Up that look.
When okay. The whole start being artistic.
He dyes his hair red. He goes to help. I feel like the one good thing about this finale that I liked was that he went to help Sebiok's brother, gave him to that woman to raise, and gave her like a suitcase of cash to help her, because you could see that the bank or whatever had taken away her store. So it could help her get back on her feet and, you know, help the boy.
That's stuff like he should have done months ago.
That is the one decision he made that I really, really liked. So moving on from that, he's, you know, taking a flight to go and visit his daughter.
Yeah, but then he now turns back because
that
he receives a phone call.
No freaking
I mean, what the hell are you going to do, Gi-hun, huh? Tell me, Gi-hun. go what are you going to do?
Cops again? Or
report
what?
To the police. Start your own agency to fight them. Go on a one-man hunt. Go back into the game. What the hell are you going to do?
I mean, clearly these people you're up against are really powerful. They know everything about your
and
life.
And let's not forget the fact that these people willingly signed over their lives. Like,
do you understand? You entered into a contract.
So I don't even know if there's anything the law can do
about
it. Because they let you go. They didn't hold you against your will. They let you go. You came back. So what the hell? What the hell? What the hell, Gihun? I hope I'm saying his name right.
Guys, all in all, the finale completely sucked. It made no sense for him to just go
just completely took
180
me out of it. Took me
on
out of
us. I was expecting a well-deserved end. Like, a better end. That's what I was expecting.
Just tell us what you thought about the finale. If you liked it, you hated it. If you feel we're not getting it right, please leave your thoughts down below so that we can really then get back to you.
Yes, guys. So until we come your way again,
stay blessed. Stay blessed.